What's that song that you were working on? A protest song?
Oh, that Save the Whales?
Yeah, yeah, I guess that's it.
Yeah, yeah. Play. Save the whales. Hey, funky mama, save the whales. They're pretty bad to save those whales. Save those big, fat, funky whales. Well, save all the whales. But shoot the seals.
All right, y'all. Got my gear here. Squiddly squid. And I'm going crabbing. Pier looks beautiful. Bit windy though, but. Oh, hey. Got it at Walmart. For like 40 bucks. Oh, yeah. Are you going all the way to the end? Oh, yeah, okay.
I'm not great fishing, I'm just figuring it out.
Oh, okay. Hello. No, everybody's amateur. Yeah, I am too.
All right, man. Check you later. Thanks a lot.
All right, guys. Here we go. I got my stuff ready. My gear. Going fishing. CrabZilla got a new concept on the crab snare. And I want to share it with you guys. I hope you guys be surprised off it because it's all based on science and done some research, and then I actually took me like a few months to build this thing, but once you see it, it's gonna blow your mind. Hey, hey, what's up, guys?
How are you?
Hi, how are you? Oh man, you guys are back.
Yeah.
Nice.
Check it out. We got some.
Oh wow. Oh wow, look at that crab. Nice.
Can't wait to eat them. Hopefully we get a few more.
Yeah, you know these guys right here, guys? They actually caught a striper with a sabiki.
Yeah, that was
incredible.
It.
Yeah, you guys are legends, man.
That's the way.
Thanks. Catch some more crabs. Here's my crab snare designer.
Hey, there it is.
Woohoo!
Made it.
I made it. My snare designer's right here.
He's got his prototype that he came out with. We want to see if that shit works for good.
Yeah. Oh, man, I know. I want to test it out.
I hope it
pays off. Oh, yeah, that would be great. But see, what I really want to do is catch a female crab.
And then that's what you were saying about the
pheromones, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, guys, this is it. The revealing of the new CrabZilla crab snare. Oh, that's sick.
You gonna get this cast on video?
Freaking sick.
Huh?
Yeah.
Let's do it.
All right. You gonna cast right now?
Yep.
All right. Go ahead.
This is the legal way of casting. Your lessons are only gonna cost you $1.98.
Flare your nose.
Maybe a little more, depends how cute you are.
Flare your nose.
What's that? Look at me clear my nose.
All right, I got on the D. Loomis.
Honored.
Yeah, you're welcome. I'm honored.
All right.
Here he goes. He's going to underhand cast.
I gotta work on my underhand.
I know, same with me. I'm not that great underhand, too.
Hey, thank you, brother.
Oh, yeah, in time, man. Yeah, you're part of it now. Right on, man.
So original.
I'm gonna be making some more of these. When I get more.
How long do you think it took you to make it?
That one only took me, as well, the concept and all that is about like about 4 months. Yeah, it's doing some studying and
right,
stuff,
right.
You know, but yeah, but he's the one who designed the snare part.
The cage, the loops, and all that.
And the arm that came off, I wanted to be like a praying mantis.
Yeah, it looked pretty sick.
Basically, if you put four loops on it, it was cool. But I said, so he had an arm that went off the back with the... But he had it backwards, so we switched it around and we said, hey, I think it's better to put it this way.
Yeah. Making different designs
ideas. We messed around with it a few nights drinking, and then all of a sudden one night I said, here, you do this. And he did it, and then we looped it, and then we put the main line to the snare actually weaves through that part that sticks out, and then bolts help hold the cage together, because we decided to weigh the thing the other night. It was like, what, 11 point...
11 point something ounce.
3 ounces.
It's pretty heavy. That's because I put two weights on the front, which I shouldn't have done that. I should have made it lighter. You know?
So he took one of
and
these...
And before I put a fiberglass...
One of these weights I make that fit inside the cage, he cut it in half and put it there. He said, how much are these? And I said, dude, I don't know. I know they're from 4 to 6.
I
can pour them. Yeah. You know, but I never weighed them. I just made it to fit in a cage. And
hey, man, that's just gonna look so cool when you pull a crab up with that thing.
Yeah, when I pull up a crab, it's gonna look cool, man.
Hey, I'm not even gonna lie too. When I was like, should I cast it? I'm like, fuck, I'm gonna be the guy that snaps this somehow.
Nah, that's all right, man. The whole thing's a big test.
I'm like, fuck.
Nah, that's a 40-pound Tesla braid. So. Of course, I'm gonna have a thick line on my from a test. Yeah, I don't want to look. Oh damn, it snapped. So it's like, oh shit. And plus, I use this for my surf casting. You know, to go catch like bass, stripers, and perch on the beach.
I'll start saving them, man. If you want, me and my kids, we walk up and down. We see all these little ones. You know.
Yeah, the 4-inch rock crabs. That's the one I want, man. All
right.
If you get one, man, I'll make you one. I make a special one for you.
You're getting away from the scientific part of it. So the thing is there's a storm that hit. So a lot of shit's dead, and crabs are dead. Crabs are cannibals. Yep. So this is laying on the bottom like this, looking like a dead crab. So the other crabs are going to come and feed on it.
Now
we're thinking about getting a female crab catcher. Tear her guts out, put it in the guts of the crab.
You put me up on the science of it, man.
Yeah.
Awesome.
So this is pretty much pure science. It's not like a crab snare that somebody just made a mold. You know, it's you know.
And then we just found out a girl that can take your shit and you describe, say like if he gave her that. So then we decide to make the snare part smaller and the shell part smaller to where you're under like 6 ounces, 6 to 8. You're in the ball game.
Perfect.
That one's a little big. It's a little heavy. The size ain't really that. Don't matter, because if you look at Hector's snares, they look like a dollar fucking pancake. But guess what? They work.
They
because
hit,
his shit's laid out. It's like half of the body size of a crab. So you know the crab's out there. He did his homework on his snares.
Yeah.
And they look a little funny, and they'll catch a lot of wind and shit. Granted, they catch crabs.
Nice.
And guess what? He ain't got a picture of Yoda on there. Superman, Batman, let's smoke pot or whatever. Yeah. It should say IHOP, dollar pancake on this shit or something. You know?
Well, make it look like a Craig R. Rims.
With pancake crab. Who knows?
Pancake crab.
Because you take gooey ducks and you skin them. You know, gooey ducks. You grind them up in a meat grinder. You take that buttermilk pancake, make a batch, mix that up in there, and then fry them fuckers, and guess what, dude? You're sitting back with a big old fat belly.
You're missing some gooey ducks, man.
Gooey ducks.
a couple of these last conversations we had.
Well, you know what?
You keep talking about gooey ducks.
I need to get my ass back up to Washington and get out in the woods. Oh, hey, watch this.
Hey,
George,
what are you
doing? George, watch this, man. I'm going to do, what's the dude's name?
He's going to do a gooey duck.
Ready?
You're doing it wrong.
Ready? It's up here, bro.
You're doing it wrong.
I'm watching it.
I got him last night on that. I got him last night, man.
You did that last night?
Yeah, I went like this. Night, I went see me float. I went like this. Want see me float? Okay, here we go. He got holy shit.
Oh, your other foot did go off. And yeah, we were fucking laughing. And then he says, here, I'll try it over here. How's it look? And he does. And there was a light there. I said, your shadow of your foot. The shadow of the fucking foot.
Then he went to the garage for a long while. I don't know what the fuck he was doing.
He was practicing
how I did it. you can do it.
Show him how you, this dude's got all this candy ass shit. Show him how your thumb.
What?
Disconnect.
Everybody knows the thumb.
That's like when you're a kid, yo. Yeah, look at that. See, look.
No, he's got it. That's a good one. Is that a good one?
Yeah, he got that shit.
He got that one. That one was a good one. I laughed my ass off.
Yeah, it was like hella cracking. I was like, holy shit. I never thought you knew it. You didn't know that.
Dude, I probably did when I was in first grade or something.
I used to do that to kids all the time. They all laugh and like, what the hell? They're like grabbing my hand, trying to pull my thumb. Female. Let's do it. Cheaper female. Let's do it. Let's get the pheromones.
Let's measure it first.
Get the pheromones. That looks like a keeper. Hi. Measure it. You got your measure?
No, it's somewhere.
It works. More excited to see you than
the crowd. Does she want that?
Huh? If that's she has to have a gauge. Fuck, this thing's over 6 inches.
Got a keeper. We got one. Yep, one female.
A keeper or what?
Yeah, 6 inch. 6 inch female. Okay, now. Get my knife back. So you stab him right here because his heart and his brain's actually right here. That's where the crab's brain is, actually. So, how we're gonna do this? See right here? That's their mating glands. See this right here? That's where they shoot out their pheromones from in here. That's where their mating glands are. And usually when the crab is molting, that's when they actually get them. They have sex that way from the molting. I don't want to really take it all the way out, but, oh shit, still moving a little.
This is our theory on crab.
We have crab here that we shit. Made out of a smaller female crab. Out of a smaller female crab. A snare like that. That's called a snare. And so the theory is crabs are cannibalistic. So we're going to take this female, use her, her guts.
Open your hand, dude. Your hand, your hand.
No. And then that should attract, we're hoping to nail her. So we're
there it goes. There it goes.
It will work.
See, I'm not gonna detach the whole thing because by law,
yeah,
we're supposed to have it attached still. So now I'm just putting all the pheromones and all the insides here. See, that's where the egg sacs are supposed to be, right here. So we could take this off. Yeah. See, I'm gonna take the inside out.
All the wings and everything else.
Yeah, all the. I wish I had a spoon. Be better. No, I'm a spill it. There.
It still looks juicy, man.
Yeah, that's the juices. This is the brain. It's right in the center. But I don't want to have it detached. That's the only problem, because then it'll be illegal. It out.
Fucking Filipino that don't even know how to clean crab. This is fucking unbelievable.
Get that butter, boy. Oh yeah. There you go.
With a little bagel.
Good.
All we need is one of those little pairs of scissors I have.
Yeah, that'll be nice. Oh, there it goes. That one right there. See those? That's the guts, intestinals. All right.
Well, hold on.
Yeah.
Oh, hold on.
Guys, if this works, this is gonna be crazy.
We took made a snare out of a smaller crab. So we're actually doing a little time crab job. So now we put all the bone monsters
down to the sea. Camera, reel it in. Damn. Dude. There is a crab. Something on there.
Yeah. So that's a crab that just caught a crab.
Yep.
Crab in here?
Handcuffed.
Well, this is what we made here. Let's go this way.
We take this up. Should we?
See what we did? So now we got the female. We got her arm.
Yes, and I was just telling you.
It's gonna go in here.
Yeah.
This one's too small, so she's going back.
Yeah, we're throwing that one back. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I'm telling you, people down there.
CrabZilla crabs there. Check this out. These are the pheromones of the female crab.
Oh, sorry, I stopped.
There's a female crab pheromones, which we're going to put the juice there and marinate it. When they're fat like this, that's a female. The male is more thin. Hey Chris, what's up, man? Check out my new CrabZilla design crabs there.
How's it work?
It's a female rock crab that's 4 inches legal. And what I do, I take the female dungy crab and take the inside, the pheromones, put it inside here with the bait. So it sits like this on the bottom, look like a dead crab. And you know how crabs are cannibalistic. And when they see a dead crab, they, and the smell of the pheromones, they'll go after it. especially if it's a male crab and they during the molting season.
Look at that. Run, crab!
Run, crab.
Run, crab, flip yourself over. Come on, you can do it. You can do it. You can escape.
Heavier contest than that fucking leader line.
Oh.
I think this is like 10 pound test. Almost.
There you go. Dennis is gonna eat a grass shrimp. Grass shrimp. Yummy. Taste it. It's pretty good. All right, yeah. You know, it's good luck.
Out, just chew it out of the shell.
Just take the head out.
Oh, that's fucked up because you can eat a lot of those when you're fishing.
Yeah.
Now just crunch it out of the shell, though.
Pretty good, huh? Yeah. Oh, yeah. A ceviche. Yep. Make ceviche with that. It's real good. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Just don't do it to a sand crab, though. Sand crabs are the... I would need a sand crab. Hey, y'all. Want to see my crab snare?
I'll be back.
Dude, watch. Show me.
Want to see my crab snare?
Yeah.
The new CrabZilla crab snare. I'll be back.
I'll be back.
I'll be back,
we
Jack.
Hold the fish. Yeah.
Do the fish dance.
Guaranteed.
There you go. Crab dance.
I'll show you this, but don't. I can't show. See, there's the crab I just caught, right? Yeah, that was a camera. Yeah, don't get excited. Watch them too.
Oh, he's trying to show that girl's armpit again. All right, action. What is your casting technique?
It's illegal.
He's gonna do the nuclear bombardier. There he goes. Wah! Damn, that thing went far. Shit, man. I think it hit that rock over there and bounced off and came right back down there. Hey, that was a good cast. Shit. Yeah, one time they told me, hey man, cast straight, man. And I told them.
I know it's gonna go out that way.
The last time I checked, I was castrated.
Yeah, I was fucking casting as fucking much as I can straight. All I know is that as long as I get as far as I can, I have a chance to be able to maneuver around everyone else.
Hear that, guys? You're talking to a pier master here.
As long
Master
as
Peerer.
Tangle or not, you guys will figure it out, man. Just be nice.
Yeah.
Just don't use braid.
What? I'm using braid.
I recommend do not use braid. If you're going to be where next to shoulder.
Yeah, that's
like
true.
Like fishing, just use straight mono or fluorocarbon. Reason is because braid will cut through that shit like...
Yeah.
Fucking knives through freaking these guys' lives.
Yeah, braids are pretty strong. Yeah, especially I use like 40 pounds, but I do use that for, I don't really crab, that's why. Yeah. I usually like surf cast or perch fishing. Yeah. These are my friends from Modesto. You guys, if you see them, check out their crab snares. Can you explain more about the crab snare? Dude, they make some great crab snare. Look how big that is, a lot of surface area. Even has a glue stick on there. And he said something about the rubber band is made for
military
grade, yeah.
Yeah, with the 100-pound rock mason leader.
Wow. And this is about how many test line?
It's 100 pound.
That's a 100-pound test line.
Yeah.
Wow. And how many ounces did you make? I mean, like, the
this
weight.
This one happens to be a six.
That's a 6 ounce?
I make sixes, sevens, eights, nines, tens.
Nice.
I weigh them out to what the actual trap weighs.
Wow.
That way you're getting an accurate weight.
Introduce yourself.
My name's Kevin McWilliams.
Yeah. If you ever see Kevin out here, you know, say hi to him. And he's selling them for a really good price, only like, what, how much, 20 bucks?
Yeah, 20 bucks.
20 bucks, yeah.
You get two for 40 with a set of glow sticks.
Two for 40 with glow sticks.
Yep.
The glow sticks last 3 days.
Yeah. And she made the glow stick, guys. You got to help their school out. The school, donate fun to their school. Right on, Kevin. Yeah. Yeah, guys. You guys are on CrabZilla. Right on, brother.
Right on. Thank you.
Take care. Hi, kiddo.
Question is, yeah. Is our kids YouTube?
No. I don't have kids so I can watch. Oh,
okay.
I don't have regular YouTube. I have kids. We'll make.
Hey, you want to see me float? You ever see anyone float? I can float. Here, okay, watch. Okay, watch this. I might get tired though, but I'll show you. Right about here. Takes a lot of energy. Here, you wanna put the camera on there? So you can see me float? Okay, you guys ready? You ready? Okay, look at my feet. Hey, let's change the
stairs.
Okay, I'll try it.
Either way, I'm not gonna tell you
the difference.
Oh! I saw!
Oh!
I saw that!
I almost fell! You didn't see it? I floated!
Did that?
That's incredible, wasn't it? Wow! She's tripping. How'd you do that? That's incredible. It's like, whoa. Huh?
That's what he did. He just did
that. No, I didn't. I can't tell you secrets. It's magic.
Do I do it again? Hold the camera right there?
No, you know what it is? Because when I ate that 7-Eleven hot dog, it gave me gas, and actually the gas made me float. I felt like helium. And the only way I brought it back down, you didn't smell something funny, I had to release it. No, okay, that was a bad joke. That was bad. Yeah, you gotta pass it, you know? It's like, hey, you know, caring is sharing. Oh, God, don't go downwind from me, I tell you. Hey, these kids are awesome. Gotta go.
This is my dad, this is my mom.
This is my father. This is my mom. This is my sister. See, she's a person. Another person. Mommy, Yes. Did you get anything?
Name.
I'm a person.
Oh no!
No!
It's hidden!
Look, the chair's floating!
Oh, look at
it! Did you go back home? Ah, man. Go up there, talk to everybody, just ahead of you. Hey, have you caught any fish today? And
Is it okay if I put the camera like this?
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay.
Look, your dad caught something, look.
Did he catch something?
Yeah.
Don't hold that too far over.
Yeah, he caught something.
What?
Oh, he's a baby.
A baby. I can't see anything now. Now it's kind of hard because I can't see anything with this.
What?
A watermelon.
Oh.
Hey, you get it?
What did the one melon say to the other melon when he wanted to get married?
I can't see anything.
He said a cantaloupe.
What are you doing?
I can't see anything. Is this off?
No, it's on. It's
what?
On.
Baby.
What?
It's
and
on.
How do you see? It's a little baby.
It turns off like that, that's so it saves the battery.
Oh.
Pretty cool, huh?
Yes.
That's so cool. Family YouTube.
There you go.
Yeah. Yes. Hi.
Oh, you're gonna throw me in on it, huh?
Throw me in the bucket. Hey, what happened? I don't know. You left it there. You're too busy talking.
No! Do a joke.
Yes, so, mister.
No. Do a joke.
Dude, that was cool. I shot two keepers. I was there.
I told you, I sent something to Duck. Hey, that was good.
No.
Yeah,
that's awesome, man.
It's like, wow. Oh, I got it
on
video, too.
Hi. Oh, you give the kids on video? Yeah. So you could send it.
Vloggers now. Look,
is that thing on there still?
You need to go to the bathroom.
Come on. They're tubers. They're YouTubers.
Here you go.
All right. Thank you.
You. These are the two YouTuber kids. Yeah.
Your turn? Why, you want to make a video? Why, you make a video. You make a video. And I'll send you the... Yeah, inside these things right here when you...
I won't share this with nobody. But
no, go ahead, share it. Nah, it's fine.
I got it.
See right here? That's where the pheromones come out of. This is where the mating happens, all right here on the crab. Yeah, so the male crab is what everyone's actually after. Because the male crab has more meat than a female crab does.
At certain times of the year.
Yeah.
In reality, the females in the back part have more meat than the males.
Yeah.
They just want the big fish because they're late and they're too white. White people like all the best part, but they don't know what the best part is. It
wasn't for women in the world, no doubt.
Right?
Serious. All right. He grinds. He knew where I was coming with that. You know, we'll be talking about eating pussy and shit.
All right. So how you want to do this? Okay, Dennis is going to show how it works. He's going to put it with some bait. Mix it with bait. There you go. So there's a pheromone. He sticks it right inside the crab. That's a female pheromone. Hey, how's it going? That's a female pheromone from that female crab, which is the which you call the butter. And when the pheromones are open like that with the crab snare, it looks like a dead crab. To a male dungeness, it makes them feel like it's molting. So when they feel like they're molting, that's when they usually mate. So the theory is, it's supposed to attract more male Dungeness crabs. Oh, no.
Spilled the sauce.
Dip this in there. Marinate it. Oh, there's some more right here, falling.
It's okay, it's gonna run out. There's nothing we can do until we gotta marinate the other bait in it, but we're out here on a rough trial.
Yeah. All right. Want to be the honor to cast it?
No. Have more too.
All right.
Watch yourself. Go.
All right. Want to be the honor to cast?
Video.
Yeah.
This one
has the pheromones.
The crab in
there. Yeah, they got the hormones of the crab, the pheromones, yeah. So the crab juice, we're saving the crab juice in here. Oh, and we're gonna marinate a bait with the crab's pheromones all mixed together. So let's see if it'll work.
Right now, okay.
Yeah.
So how'd you get it? You just poked it or something?
Yeah, we took it right out of the female because this is the reproductive chambers of the female.
Yeah.
So when they molt, that's where they actually mate.
Yeah.
But when they hold each other like this.
Yeah. You got the female.
So yeah. So we got the insides of the female. This one has like sort of like egg sac things. That's not fully
that's
like idea.
That's
you know.
It right there or no?
Yeah, so the juices itself, we actually see, look at this, the juices itself
shit into that. Yeah.
We marinate it,
your fucking scraps there.
Yeah,
so
the idea is like little bags in here.
Yeah, it's right in there already.
Yeah.
All right,
I want to try that idea actually.
Try it.
Yeah,
You want some more? I got some more out here.
I'll grab,
you grab this.
Where are you getting it from? From there?
From inside, see?
I got it.
See all that stuff? That's all pheromones.
Is it female? You're going to want
that's
the female.
That's a female. Yeah, and that's 6 inch.
Yeah.
So that's a good size. Oh, damn. What's that? That's bigger than your thing, man.
Well, that's the
all right.
I'll grab that. Here, come here.
Want to be the first,
Let's go, man.
One to cast?
Yeah. Hell yeah.
All right. Okay. Take one. This is where he's going to cast the test crab pheromones for the male crabs attractant that we actually pulled out from the female. And
No.
Oh, that's all right.
Oh, was I supposed to? Oh, shoot.
Oh, yeah.
That. Sorry.
No, I didn't want it. It's just that, the game warden, they wanted all attached together.
Shit. Okay.
Yeah, if you cleaned it that
you
way.
Keep the shell with it.
Yeah, you have to have the shell with it.
Sorry, who's this?
Huh?
Whose crab is this? Is this yours?
Well, it's mine.
Oh, it was ours. Sorry, man. We can always throw it back out.
No,
you gotta keep it.
You gotta keep the shell. Yeah,
go ahead and do it.
I think I already got it. I'm good.
All right.
Underhand, huh?
Underhand.
Yeah.
It'll be all right? Cast it right here. Right about here is nice.
No.
All right. Gonna have to reel it up a bit to about 4 feet.
I'm still a little new at that.
All right, there you go.
Take Dennis's approach with the 7 o'clock, 2 o'clock or something like that.
7 o'clock, 2 o'clock or something. Try it.
Here we go.
Swing it. All right.
Crab snare. Put the squeeze in there.
Yeah.
Fly.
It's going to a flight. The flight crab. Nice. That was a good one. It's always good if you didn't snap it. I usually loosen it up and just put it down and tighten it, you know? So I have enough room for it to just sit there, you know?
I'm just so worried about this goddamn
beautiful
snare, man.
Thank you, man.
I don't want to lose it, you know?
This expensive pull.
Well, in that
you know, see this?
Can you picture losing it on the first
No.
I know, that'd be terrible, man.
You brought out this pull. Right
there. Yeah.
But the thing is, a stiffer rod with this 40 and then bling it.
This thing will fly.
It's like 11 ounces, so it is a little too heavy.
Yeah. The next one I'm going to
make. Guys, enjoy your day and happy Easter.
Bye. Happy Easter. The next one I'm going to make is going to be, it's going to be awesome, man. It's going to be more lighter in weight. And you can add weight on it, too, if you want to.
I'm going to keep the even the small ones for you.
Oh, right on.
Find the little ones?
Yeah, the 4 inches? Yeah. Maybe if you could, I'll make you one, man. I'll make you one.
You have to get a small one. And you have to make a mold out. The thing is, no matter what species it is, it's illegal.
Well, not if you're pulling them up on the
end
of the beach.
It's illegal.
Yeah, it's still illegal on the beach.
It's like a
dead animal. No, I'm saying like it's dead on the fucking, just a carcass on the beach. Like, we take those home all the time. My kids love how they look, you know?
Oh, yeah.
They're not alive.
Yeah, just a shell.
Yeah, they've already been caught by the seagulls and shit. Yeah.
They catch up and they clean
they're
them.
They're all hollowed out. That's where I'm like, oh, this beach is cool, man. There's a lot of empty fucking shells.
Yeah, those are the poachers.
Yeah.